Hello everyone, today we are going to see conjunctions and types of conjunctions. In grammar, conjunction is a part of speech that connects words, phrases or clauses. First, we have to know what is meant by a phrase. A phrase is a group of words that express a concept and is used as a unit within a sentence. In other words, it is a group of words that adds meaning to a sentence. It does not have both a subject and a verb. Next, we have to know what is meant by a clause. A clause is a group of words that contains a verb and usually other components too. A clause may form part of a sentence, or it may be a complete sentence in itself. Students, now let's see one example sentence. I love sport and I am captain of the local football team. In this sentence, I love sport is a main clause and is a conjunction. I am captain of the local football team is a main clause. Now, we are going to see what is a conjunction. A word or group of words that connect two or more words, clauses, phrases or sentences are called conjunctions. Conjunctions are called joining words. So, students, what is a conjunction? A word or group of words that connect two or more words, clauses, phrases or sentences are called conjunctions. Conjunctions are called joining words. Conjunctions are very important words used in English. A conjunction is a word that joins parts of a sentence, phrases or other words together. Conjunctions are used as single words or in pairs. Example, and, but, or are used by themselves, whereas neither, nor, either, or are conjunction pairs. Next, we are going to learn about types of conjunctions. So, there are three main types of conjunctions. First one is coordinating conjunctions. Second one is subordinating conjunctions. And the third one is correlative conjunctions. So students, let's see it one by one in detail. First, we are going to learn about coordinating conjunctions. Coordinating conjunctions link two or more words, clauses, phrases or sentences of equal importance. In other words, the conjunctions which join clauses of equal rank are called coordinating conjunctions. So students, what is meant by coordinating conjunctions? Coordinating conjunctions link two or more words, clauses, phrases or sentences of equal importance. In other words, the conjunctions which join clauses of equal rank are called coordinating conjunctions. Next, let's see about subordinating conjunctions. Subordinating conjunctions are the words that links a dependent clause to an independent clause. In other words, a conjunction which connects a clause to another on which it depends for its full meaning is called a subordinating conjunction. So what is meant by subordinating conjunctions? Subordinating conjunctions are the words that links a dependent clause to an independent clause. In other words, A conjunction which connects a class to another on which it depends for its full meaning is called a subordinating conjunction. Subordinating conjunctions join an independent class. So what is meant by independent class? Independent class which contains both a subject and a verb and can act as a complete sentence, and a dependent class. So what is meant by dependent class? Dependent class which also contains a subject and a verb but is not a complete meaning. So subordinating conjunctions join an independent class and a dependent class. Example sentence: they went running although or even though it was very hot. Next, we are going to see the third type of conjunction, that is correlative conjunctions. A correlative conjunction is a type of conjunction that functions in a pair. In other words, conjunctions which are used in pairs are called correlative conjunctions. Next, we are going to learn about types of conjunctions in English. Conjunctions are classified into three types: coordinating conjunctions, subordinating conjunctions, and correlative conjunctions. First, let's see about coordinating conjunctions. Coordinating conjunctions are for and nor, but or it. So students, to remember all of the coordinating conjunctions, we can learn following acronym FANBOYS. F refers to for, A denotes and, N refers nor, B denotes but, O refers or, Y refers it, S denotes so. Next, let's see about subordinating conjunctions. Subordinating conjunctions are after, although, as far as if, as long as soon as thou, because, before, even if, when, where, wherever, even though, every time, if, in order that, since, so that, than, though, unless, until, whenever, whereas, while. Students, so these are all some subordinating conjunctions. Next, let's see about correlative conjunctions. Correlative conjunctions are either, or, not only, but also, neither, nor, both, and, whether, or, just as, so, the, as much as, no sooner, than, rather than. So these are all some correlative conjunctions. Students, now let's see it one by one in an elaborate manner. First, let's see about coordinating conjunctions. So students, what is mean by a coordinating conjunction? A conjunction that joins words, phrases, classes, or sentences that are of equal importance is called a coordinating conjunction. We use coordinating conjunctions to connect two main or coordinating classes. When we join two words, phrases, or classes of equal importance or of the same function, they become coordinating phrases or clauses, the words we use to join these two parts are called coordinating conjunctions. These join the elements that are the same. There are 7 coordinating conjunctions such as and, but, for, nor, are, so and it. Students, to remember all of the coordinating conjunctions, we can learn following acronym FANBOYS. So F refers to for, A denotes and, N refers to nor, B denotes but, O refers to or, Y refers to it, and S denotes so. So students, in this tabular column, we can see coordinating conjunctions, its meaning and example. First, we are going to learn about for. For means because. Example sentence, I want to go there again for. It was a wonderful trip. For means the exact same thing as because. The only difference is that when you use for to join two sentences together into one compound sentence, you need to use a comma before it. When you use because to join two sentences, you don't use a comma before it. Example sentence, I drank some water for I was thirsty. Next, we are going to learn about and. And is used to combine two things that are similar and equal. Example sentences, I play the piano and my sister plays the guitar. The next example sentence is, I play football and he plays cricket. The next usage is, and is used to add something to another. Example sentence, she is reading and he is painting. So what is mean by and? And means in addition to. Example sentence, we are going to a zoo and an aquarium on the same day. The third one is nor. Nor means and not. Now let's see one example sentence. Neither my parents nor my friends supported me. Students, you all know about N refers to nor. Now let's see two example sentences. I can't whistle nor can I sing. The next example sentence is, he didn't study last night nor did he read his book. Here nor means also not. Nor requires unusual grammar. The first sentence will contain a negative verb, whereas the second sentence will contain what looks like an interrogative affirmative verb form. An auxiliary verb do, does, did, is, am, or, was, were. Modal verb like can, could, will, would, may, might, must, should, or. Be main verb is am or was were, comes after nor and before the subject, and then the main verb comes after the subject. Next, we are going to learn about but. But is used for contrasting between two things. Now let's see example sentences. I called many times, but no one answered the phone. The next example sentence is, Meera came to the party, but she left early. The next example sentence is, Raina is tall, but her sister is taller. So, but connects two different things that are not in agreement. Example sentence, I am a night owl, but she is an early bird. Next, let's move on to R. R is used to show a choice or an alternative. Example sentence, you could wear jeans or trousers. Then, R is used to choose between two or more things. Example sentence, they could come with us or they could go on their own. Then, R indicates a choice between two things. Example sentence, we can go to France or stay here. Next, let's see about it. It is used to mean at the same time or nevertheless. Example sentences are, it was a difficult task. It was very interesting. The next example sentence is, we live in different cities. We are close. The next example sentence is, she dances well. She hesitates to take part in the competition. So, it indicates contrast with something. Example sentence, he performed very well. He didn't make the final cut. Finally, we are going to learn about so. So illustrates a result of the first thing. Example sentence, this song has been very popular, so I downloaded it. So students, as a whole, coordinating conjunctions are used to link or join two words or phrases that are equally important and complete in terms of grammar when compared with each other. The sentences or words do not depend on anything to give themselves meaning. For means because. Example sentence, I told her to leave for I was very tired. And means in addition to. Example sentence, I like football and I like hockey. Nor means and not. Example sentence, I have neither done the dishes nor the laundry. But means however. Example sentence, she is 85 but she still goes swimming every day. Or means either. Example sentence, I will eat either a hamburger or a hot dog. Then, it means but. Example sentence, the weather was cold, it bright and sunny. Then, so. So means therefore. Example sentence, it was still painful, so I went to see a doctor. Students, these conjunctions are always placed between the two classes or words that they are joining. Next, we are going to learn about subordinating conjunctions. So, what is meant by a subordinating conjunction? A subordinating conjunction is used to join a main class or a subordinate class. It helps to indicate time, place, purpose, condition, reason, contrast, and so on. Students, this table shows us how to use subordinating conjunctions. Subordinating conjunctions are when, while, till, until, whenever, before, after, as soon as, since. So, its function is to indicate time. Example sentence, we cannot go out until father returns home. Then, where, wherever, its function is to indicate place. Example sentence, I can take you wherever you want to go. Then, so that, its function is to indicate purpose. Example sentence, we are making a model so that we can take part in the science fair. Next, if, unless, whether, its function is to indicate condition. Example sentence, we can have a cold drink if you are thirsty. Then, because, as, since, its function is to indicate reason. Example sentence, we are making dinner because we have invited our friends for lunch. Then, though, although, its function is to indicate contrast. Example sentence, though Meera knew the answer, she did not raise her hand. Students, we use subordinating conjunctions to connect a main class with a subordinate class. The subordinating conjunctions are when, if, because, although, until, since, unless, and so on. Students, this table shows us how to use subordinating conjunctions. First, let's see about when. When is used to indicate the time when something happened or will happen. Example sentence, Veera was having lunch when the telephone rang. Next, we are going to learn about if. If is used to show that something will happen only when something else happens or comes to. Example sentence, we will watch the show if we get the tickets. Next, we are going to learn about because. Because indicates a reason why something happened or will happen. Example sentence, he went to the library because he wanted to study. Then, let's see about although. Although is used to show that in spite of something, there was a result that was different and unexpected. Example sentence, we didn't win the match although we played well. Next, let's see about until. Until is used to indicate time. Example sentence, we played outside until it was dark. Next, let's see about for. For is used to indicate a proof or explanation of something that is being stated. Example sentence, I gave him some water for he was thirsty. Next, let's see about since. Since is used to indicate cause or time. Example sentences are, Renu was absent since she was not feeling well. The next example sentence is, I was waiting for you since 3 o'clock. Next, let's see about before. Before is used to indicate a time that is earlier to what is being mentioned. Example sentence: the meal was ready before the guest arrived. Next, let's see about unless. Unless is used to refer to a necessary condition for a result. Example sentence: you will not succeed unless you work hard. Next, let's see about will. Will is used to indicate that something happened at the same time as something else. Example sentence: I listened to music while my father read a book. Students, next we are going to learn about the third type of conjunction, that is correlative conjunctions, in an elaborate manner. Correlative conjunctions work in pairs to join phrases or words that carry equal importance within a sentence. They come in pairs and you have to use both of them in different places in a sentence to make them work. They get their name from the fact that they work together, which means co, and relate one sentence element to another. Correlative conjunctions include pairs such as both and, either or, neither nor, not but, and not only but also. For example, both and, example sentence: we will have both the cheesecake and the chocolate cake. Students, we can use conjunctions like neither nor, either or, whereas to join sentences. First, let's see about neither nor. Example sentence: oh, you want neither the cheesecake nor the chocolate cake? No problem. Next, let's move on to either or. Example sentence: I want either the cheesecake or the chocolate cake. Then let's see about whereas. Rina makes friends in no time, whereas her brother is shy. Next, let's see about whether or. Example sentence: I didn't know whether you did want the cheesecake or the chocolate cake, so I got both. Next, let's see about not only but also. Example sentence: I will eat them both, not only the cheesecake but also the chocolate cake. Next, we move on to not but. Example sentence: I see you are in the mood not for desserts but appetizers. I will help you with those too. Here are some more useful pairs of correlative conjunctions: as, bowling isn't, as fun as skeet shooting. Next, let's move on to scarcely when. Example sentence: I had scarcely walked in the door when I got an urgent call and had to run right back out again. Next, let's see about as many as. There are as many curtains as there are windows. Next, let's see about no sooner than. I did no sooner lie to you than strangle a puppy. Next, let's see about rather than. She did rather play the drums than sing. Next, let's move on to both and. Both and connects either two subjects or two objects. Let's see example sentence. Both John and Lauren enjoyed the movie. So in this sentence, both and connects two subjects. The next example sentence is, John enjoyed both the movie and the company. In this sentence, both and connects two objects. Next, let's see about as. As compares nouns using an adjective or an adverb. Now let's see example sentence. A lion can't run as fast as a cheetah. Then we use even though to suggest contrast. Example sentence. The temperature was low even though it was sunny. Next, let's see about not only but also. Not only but also can connect nouns or entire classes. Example sentence. I am not only going to the concert but also meeting the band backstage. Students, now let's see some more example sentences containing correlative conjunctions. First, let's see about either or. Example sentences are, we can go to either Greece or Spain for our holiday. The next example sentence is, it's my final offer. You can either take it or leave it. Next, let's see about not only but also. Example sentence. Not only is he a professional footballer, but he is also a successful businessman. Next, let's move on to not but. Example sentence. In sport, what counts is not the winning, but the taking part. Next, let's see about neither nor. Example sentence. Neither Norway nor Switzerland is in the European Union. Next, let's see about whether or. Example sentences are, whether you love them or hate them, you have to admit that the Rolling Stones are very popular. The next example sentence is, I'm totally confused. I don't know whether I'm coming or going. Finally, we are going to see no sooner than. Example sentence. No sooner had I finished watering the garden than it started raining. I have enclosed the classbook instructions in the PDF. Kindly refer it. So now, we have reached the end of this session. Thank you.